I don't hear any music, Mac.
It's too loud.
I hate you so much.
I like that. I like that.
That's a callback from our previous episode. Hey, everybody. Welcome to That Checks Out with Damon and Jed. Gets longer every week.
Am I? Yeah.
Not in real life, though.
I was going to say, nobody likes a bragger, but it's still good.
I'm Ted. That makes him Damon. Welcome to the show. Damon, yes. How was your week, morning, day, whatever you want to talk about?
All right, so I do want to talk about, it's back to school time for kids, right? So I like the fact that everybody's putting up pictures of their kids. But if you think that's the cutest or best looking kid, you know, that I've ever seen, I'm kind of tired of seeing pictures. You know what I mean?
I am done with seeing your offspring.
Because, like, again, I know there's a meme out there, and it makes fun of, like what is it, Chunk from the Goonies. You know what I mean? Where it's like he's in his first day of school shirt, and you're like, oh, cool. We get it. Everybody's going back to school. We get it. You got a new pair of shoes and a new shirt.
It's not for us, though. It's for the parents, the next year.
Like the grandparents?
So they can get a collage. I mean, don't tell me that. You have shirts specifically for your kids that they have worn every...
Oh, yeah. Oh, they're doing it again. They did it again. It drives me nuts.
Yes.
Yeah.
And Ted, thank you for paying attention to the fact that we've been doing this for years. No, that's all I got was, no. Yeah, we do that. It drives me nuts. Can I speak of shirts for a second?
Yes.
Speaking of shirts, I asked some of our fans, Williamson, and also Timmy Blaze, to make something for me.
Yeah.
I'll explain off my why I needed two people to do this, but I would like to thank them both. Eric Williamson from the Kagazoo Whisker Crew and Timmy Blaze of the Happy Corner Podcast. Hold on 1 second. Ready for this?
Yeah.
This is going to be timely. For those not watching the video, I'm stripping in the studio.
For those not watching the video, I'm starting. Whoa. What is that? That will remain a mystery.
So we do we've done the Law and Order. Dun, dun,
I like that.
For episodes and episodes now. And I was like, right. I was looking at it. I was like, three letters. And five letters? That's us, man.
Yeah.
So now I have a new shirt that says, in the Law and Order font, Ted and Damon.
Yeah.
That will remain a mystery.
You know the only problem I have with that shirt?
Is I'm first?
Yeah.
That's nailed it. Specifically why I made this shirt.
Yeah. Nailed it.
during the last episode, Jordan sent me a text and said they should have the Law and Order sound effect. And I just pointed at the gong gong on the screen.
Did we not use it? I thought we did.
Yeah.
No.
We absolutely have episode. That.
I thought we did.
Not at that point.
Maybe we didn't at that point.
Maybe we hadn't yet.
That's our most used. Where's the Phil Collins is the one that I missed the most. Do we still have Collins on the board?
Yes.
Nice. Who has the board memorized?
I like this guy. I like that.
That's a little creepy.
Yeah.
What else? We're like 100 episodes in, man.
Yeah.
Well, I know where Have Mercy
is. I don't even know where it's at. I'm looking at it. I had to search for it. It is all labeled here in front of me.
Is that still on? I love that one. So, like I said, the back to school pictures and stuff like that. I don't mind seeing, I guess that's what social media is for, but I take it as like, if I scroll past and I don't like it, and then I put something up and you don't like what I, what's the difference? You know what I'm saying? It's just kind of weird where it's like, I have a podcast and I put something up that, hey, I have a podcast and you get like two likes. And then someone puts like I could put a picture of like Shrek in a first day of school shirt, you know, and they'd be like, oh, he's so adorable. It's like, no, he's not.
Maybe
you know?
We should do that. Maybe we should get backpacks, go stand on our street. First day of school, whatever.
Yeah. We should. And see how many likes we can get. Because we're adorable. Not in that shirt, though. It's in the wrong order.
No, this is a great shirt.
It's in the wrong order.
It's a fantastic shirt.
So, how was your week?
Well, I got an awesome shirt.
I beg to differ. So, you got a rag, but go ahead. What else? By the way, thank you for making that. That was a work and effort went into that.
Yeah.
I can see who did what. I know exactly what's going on there. So, that's pretty cool. And it's got the QR code on it, too. QR code.
So they're like, ooh, a mystery. Let me find out what's in that QR code. Just takes you to the website.
Yeah.
Not, for those of you listening, not really a mystery. For those people in the street, scan my shirt.
Yeah. Just walk up and scan me.
Just go up and point your phone right at me. I'll enjoy it.
So how was your week besides the shirt?
Yeah, it was pretty good. Not really that exciting, to be honest with you. No. Oh. So we're having dinner and I look out And it reminded me of something I'd seen earlier. And I turned to Tina and I was like, you go out there and you tell your damn bird you stays on your car. Because I came out and there was literally like a tracks. Like it's doing a design on the top of my car.
It's pacing.
We don't play that game.
Right.
I don't want your bird feet.
Yeah.
And she's like, well, that's weird. I don't know where that bird came from. I've never seen that bird. And I was
car.
I was like, you know, there's two. And she's like, what do you mean there's two? And I point out and like, right now, I'm telling you, there are two. There's two, like sitting on the chair looking at us. Like, you know, there's two. They're right.
Yeah.
They're right there.
Yeah. Well, his buddy probably showed up and be like, he's like, I own this car. So, if you want
to. Yeah. And I said last week that was doing tread flicks.
Yeah.
And here's the thing. It's like, did I tell the story that I went to the doctor and got new medicine?
Have just
I told
recently?
That in the podcast? Yeah, have I told that?
No, not recently.
See, here's the thing. He's like, hey, I noticed that your testosterone's low. And I'm like, yeah, I've been telling you that the last six times I came here because I wanted to go back on some sort of a replacement for it.
Yeah. Well, it's for energy and everything, right?
Right. Because I test, and I'm going to be very careful how I word this. My testosterone, and I'm going to be really careful how I word this. Now I can't speak.
Yeah.
My testosterone levels test out as the same levels as a prepubescent boy. I do not want to be around, near, have any desire to be affiliated with a prepubescent boy.
Other than that red ginger hair he used to have.
Yeah,
that might be nice
to
come
back.
Yeah, that might be nice to come back.
So he's like, oh, that's kind of low. I'm like, yeah. I don't even show that I have any kind of adult level. So I'm back on that. The first time I took it back in the day, that's why I stopped taking it because it didn't do anything.
Right.
Now I want to punch to this table.
Nice.
Like all the time.
He's got roid rage today. Roan rage, right? Testosterone? Okay. Roan rage.
No, it's so weird. I'm like, why am I? I'm like, the other day I was on the treadmill and I did my thing. And I later on, I'm like, well, I should do the treadmill.
Yeah.
I'd already done the treadmill, but I wanted to do it again.
Stop looking at me, treadmill. I will totally get on you.
Oh, we didn't talk about this. Like a few weeks back, I hinted that my wife had given me a project.
Yeah.
For my son's birthday.
Okay? Yeah.
Yeah. It was a 2600 Lego project.
Yeah, it looked pretty cool.
Yeah, it was pretty cool to look at. That was two nights of my life.
Yeah.
Hiding in the basement, not in my murder room.
Yeah, right.
It was the first time I used my ping pong table in a year, though.
I was going to say, it's really hard to build that when you're in handcuffs.
Yeah.
Can't get these put together. It's really hard.
Then her sister and her mom is visiting family in California, so her sister and dad came over for the birthday. Oh, is that real? Can that hook up? What does that do? Can I put games? It's Legos.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. I built an entire thing of Legos and then built a Nintendo inside of it. And inside of this TV, I built an entire screen. And I did.
Right. Right. Yeah.
What does that do? What is it? Oh, is it like, yeah, it's Legos.
Yeah.
Like you could see that it's Legos.
There's not two L's in Samsung.
I'm sorry. All you aficionados, Lego. There's no S in Legos. I apologize. It's Lego.
There's really no S.
No, it's Lego.
What about when you?
It's Lego bricks.
Okay,
that's where you get the plural.
But when there are multiple Legos on the floor.
Nope, Lego. There are multiple Lego bricks on the floor.
Oh, I'll never say that. So Lego people, you can like him and hate me. I really don't care. You know who's dead to me now?
Lego.
Lego people.
Yep. Nope. Doing this too long. My shirt and Lego people are dead.
Yes.
To you.
Yes. And I gotta tell you, Williamson and Timmy Blaze are teetering. They're teetering. Collectively, the
knocked
shirt
it out of the park.
Yeah, the shirt
knocked
is dead.
It out of the park.
But it was a while back where we did one of our most popular episodes. Actually, was the stand-up prognosticator. I think it was our episode 100 that we did that where you were saying you could go to the doctor and you had to give the bad news to people, but you had to do it like in a joke form. So I started thinking about that. What else would be great to deliver that way? Because we had our coffin confessor, right?
Right.
A couple episodes ago. So that was very cool. People really responded to that. Yeah. You know what I mean? So
weirdly, they're like, you can say whatever you want at my funeral. First off.
Right.
First off, hey, I appreciate your optimism that you're going to, this guy's going to outlive you.
Right.
So good luck with that.
Yeah. If that happens, you've made some poor choices in life.
Second off, this is the filtered version of Damon. And you told him you could say whatever he wants at your funeral.
Right. Well, my post that I put on our social media page was basically.
Which
that will remain a mystery.
Because apparently no one knows it's out there.
Right. But my post I put up there was basically that we're now for hire. We do funeral. We'd love to come to yours.
That's how
I worded it. We'd love to come to your funeral, you know, and very, very blunt.
We would do other events if you'd like, but if funeral's what we got, we'll take it.
Yeah, but it's funny how many people, you're right, sparked up and like, hey, you can do mine. And I'm like, oh, yeah, let's back up the train because you're younger than me.
Dude,
you know,
we're in. We just get Mac to play the music really loud. And I'm like, thank you for coming to this guy. Checks out. Yeah. With David and Ted.
All the people in the front row are crying. It's too loud. You know, turn it down. It's too loud.
With Damon and Ted. Yeah.
With Damon and Dad. Damon and Dad. That's exactly what it is. But
and I'm like, even when I'm doing this, I'm the one talking and I cut myself out of the title. How did that work?
Yeah, but what?
I'm at the end. You just pull the string. Embroidery comes right out.
But I even thought, like, it would be neat if they had somebody, even working at fast food when they don't have your order ready, they're like, hey, just so you know, and they just make a joke and you all can be like, pull up to the rail, you know, you know. Then maybe you get like a mime that comes out, you know, like they're getting out of the box to hand you your bag. You got to entertain me if I have to wait. That's what I'm saying. You should have maybe waiting room entertainment would be great. Go to a doctor's office and you just have to sit and wait. And like, all right, so please don't touch a fish tank. And my name's Ted, you know, and it's like.
Well, you know who they'd get for that? They'd get for the people that were like cut.
Carrot Top. That's what they get.
They'd get for people that were cut from warm-up shows. Yeah.
You know what, though? What a great audience. Come on, and go, how's everybody doing tonight? Yeah. They're all the doctor.
You know, the you see him out back smoking with all the nurses. Right. Last week, I was on Seth.
Yeah. Right.
I thought I was going to get a call for the Daily Show warm up, but no, here I am.
Last week, I'm eating cantaloupe in a green room with Seth. Yeah. This week.
All right. Hold on. I got to go back in.
Yeah.
Code blue. That's me. I got to go.
Next week, I got a hospice gig I'm going to, you know. You know, what do you do? You know, that would just be so, but that would be neat. Like waiting rooms. Same thing. You're getting your car worked out anywhere. You have to wait. That might be kind of neat to have somebody that just kind of it's filler. Yeah. You know what I mean? It's filler. And then like they're going to get in their ear like, hey, tell Damon, tell Mr. Paracchio, it's going to be $275 to do an alignment.
You know, I was just going to say, what are they like talking about? Jiffy Lube?
Yeah.
Hey, I'm going to need some real energy on this one because this guy's car is effed.
Yeah. Just so you know, he needs way more than wiper blades. All right. Yeah. So here.
He's going to need work that Jiffy Lube can't provide.
So you see the comedian taking notes. He's like, all right, I'm going to open with wiper blades. All right. I'm going to transition to trans flush. All right. Trans flush. And then I'm going to let him know radiator shot. Okay. Yeah. Radiator shot. So cannot fix the AC.
Hey, you got a good joke for this guy's car has zero oil in it and he's going to need a new engine.
Right.
I'll tell you what, I've experienced it and I don't.
Right. Either that or what if they did like a lounge singer? So it's not just a comedian, but like a lounge. So the lounge singer's like, you know, Mr. Paracchio, your car's just playing it on the piano. And then all of a sudden, it's piano man, Billy Joel, you know, he's going to town, but he has to break the news to you about stuff. You know, that would really be great. I will tell you though, as somebody who's been like in that industry, it's very hard to go out and sit in a waiting area next to a customer, okay, and talk about their car and what it needs in front of other customers. Because you think about it, at a doctor's office, you don't do that.
Right.
You bring them in. You don't come out and go, so I hear you have a rash, you know, and like the whole room's there. Like, so how's that rash on your beehole? Is that, how's that going? Is that going pretty good? You know, and everybody else is like, you know, you don't do that. It's very hard to, not to deliver, it's not that it's bad news, but you're on the spot.
Like, I just really want to picture your lounge singer guy, like, guess who's back? Back again. Yeah. Syphilis is back. Yeah. Tell your friends.
Yeah. You got it from your friends. Yeah. Yeah.
Right. Everyone else in the waiting room was like, ooh.
And then he turns and he goes, sorry, I was singing to you.
You are Mr. Johnson, right? No. That would be that guy. We've talked about this, Jerry.
Yeah.
Ask first.
Yeah. I was going to sing a song, but nothing rhymes with micro penis. So I don't know. You're Mr. Johnson, right? No.
No. He's Mr. Micro Johnson. Yeah.
They call me Lil J. Yeah, that would just be so great, though. You're like, listen, I've been trying to compose for a half hour. Nothing rhymes with micro penis. You got it. Have a nice day.
Double down, go again. Hey, like, here's a coupon for free Arby's. Yeah. That's all we got.
And I'd be like, cool. You know, it's a lot easier to deal with this. You know, wait a minute. You could get 2 for $6 anywhere. This isn't a coupon.
It's not a coupon.
You just wrote down, asked for 2 for $6.
It's written on a note card. It says, flip over and it says, say thanks.
It's written on a note card that just says, yikes.
Well, on the back of it, so you're holding it up, reading it to the person on the back of it, it says, I have a micro penis.
So ooh, wait, sorry, I'm supposed to hand it to you the other way.
Right, right. Sir, we only, that'd be great. They only deliver bad news on coupons.
Hey, Dr. Franklin, I ruined that HIPAA thing again.
Yeah.
What's the rules on that?
Yeah, right. You didn't tell me you had 2 for $6, did you? No, I told him about the other thing. You know, the micro thing.
Hey, can we get that lady in here and ask her if she can make sex rooms and HIPAA rooms?
Right, yeah. That would be so great, though. That, you know, you, I think you're onto something. Maybe we have a business idea right here.
Wait, I don't know anything I did in there with a business idea.
No, coupons that give you bad news, but they're like totally unrelated. Like you're saying, like, all right, you only have 3 weeks to live. Here's a 5 for $5 over at Arby's, you know?
I think it's a coupon. This is a coupon. It just tells me I can get free fries if I download the app.
Flip it over. You're dying.
That was the good news side.
Yeah.
I'm supposed to read that side second.
Oh, hey, you know what?
Wait, oh, you're disappointed in that? You're really going to hate the other side.
You're going to hate the other side. You know, you actually started on side B. You're supposed to start on A. I'm just letting you know. So.
Ooh. Maybe have your wife read the other side to you.
Yeah, right. Right. Wow. No, I like that. It got a little off the rails, but I like where that goes. So it's either going
like
to be
the idea of having people that aren't coupons. They just tell people how to use like available discounts
or how to order. Yeah. Pull up, run over the beeper, and go, "Hello." It's like, this is not a coupon.
That first voice is recorded.
Yeah.
Wait for the second voice.
Yes. Say no. You did not use the app. Say no.
You are not using your app today.
Yeah. That's exactly right.
Last week when I was in Kenosha with when we leave,
yeah,
John always wants to get a drink and everything. So when the pandemic was happening, the only thing that was open was McDonald's.
Gotcha.
So now it's just like rote with it. We go to McDonald's, and every time they do it, I'm gonna use my app today. I'm always in the other seat. No, he's not. And then we pull around. He's like, "What did they ask me?"
Yeah,
they're always asking you if you want to use the app.
Yeah, the first question is on a recording. You could go to the oldest McDonald's on the face of the earth. The first question is recorded. Are you using the app today?
So. The first time I didn't answer for him, we just sat there for a while and it was just like, well, oh, I think they broke John. No, the answer is no. And he wants an iced tea.
His coupon you had him just says, say no, then order.
Say no.
Yeah.
Sorry about your O-ring.
Yeah. All right. Right.
Onion rings. Nope. That's the other side.
Yeah.
I told you not to put onion rings and the O-ring on the same one, guys. It's confusing. Yeah. Wow. I don't even think we could see the rail station anymore. We're so far off the rails.
No, that was, you know what though? It started with what would be a good idea for a comedian to deliver bad, you know, deliver news for, and turn into awesome coupons.
Yeah, we put on our track shoes and ran with that.
Yeah, it was fun. So, hey, let's do a couple fun facts then.
All right.
We'll follow that up with fun facts. I made them all about me today, all right?
So Wait.
Yeah.
Wait. Fun facts about you. Yeah, something doesn't fit there.
They're all about me.
One of these things doesn't belong here. Hey. One of these things isn't the same.
I have 4 of them because they're all about me. So here's the first one. Having a hairy chest has been linked to higher intelligence in men. That's a proven fact. I'm Italian. Need I say more? I'm probably
please
smartest
do,
guy in this
so
room.
Far.
Yeah. You're not following?
No.
Should I hand you a coupon with directions? Get on board. That's what it says. Ooh.
Ooh.
Ooh. And a free fry. Okay. Great. No, it's a fact. Having a hairy chest has been linked. Linked.
Linked.
Linked.
Linked.
So direct responsibility for higher intelligence.
It's the same guy that found out that fish can fake it.
Yeah, right.
That's the problem with these.
That's what happened when they questioned him on the fish. You're not real. Have I also told you? And he unbuttons his shirt.
That's the problem with these episodes is that we probably had other scientific fact 75 episodes ago, but I can't remember it. So I got to go back to the most recent episode.
Yeah.
Is that like the guy that did the thing last week?
Right. So
I love when people go to me like they'll say something. I'm like, oh, was that something I said? Is that something Damon said? Is that from a show that we did? Is that from a show on TV I don't watch? Yeah. I don't want to look like an idiot, but
so the second one, okay,
Having a dark sense of humor has been linked to higher intelligence. This is all about how intelligent I am. I think you need to get on board with
this. Did you just write this list?
It's in crayon. It's a picture of my construction paper.
I used to do that back in the day. I'd be like, I need a copy of this. Ooh, let me get my colored pencils.
Yeah, right.
They're like, what?
Yeah.
Like, God, you're an idiot.
I can't draw it from memory, so you're going to have to hold it up.
Yeah. You said you wanted color, right?
Yeah. No tracing. You know, that may... Not to get off track, but that's so
too late.
Like we don't anyway. But that's what gets me too is the no tracing. So you have something the exact perfect size because you always end up making it bigger or smaller. You know, I love. Just recently, I watched somebody try to make poster signs. It's the greatest thing when you get happy across the top and you get the birth duh and you have no room for AY. It's like you have totally sized this the wrong way. Yeah. You know, if happy goes the whole way across the board, there's no way birthday is going to be the same size letters. Yeah. Okay.
I want birthday to be bigger.
Yes. Right. Do you want to put a hyphen in birthday? Yeah, is it going to be birth?
Instruction paper.
Yeah. Right. Just tape it to the side. It'd be world's worst protester. He's got two signs. You got to hold them side by side.
Two sticks.
Yeah. Are you protesting for two? Yeah. Maybe. You know, you never know.
That guy's two sticks dumb.
Yeah. Right. Well, at least you know there's, you make one hoping that there's another guy that feels the same way as you. You're like, come on, man. I made the sign. Someone's got to feel this way. But I saw that and I was just like, if happy stretches from side to side, I'm just letting you know the next word is significantly bigger.
I would stop him. I'd let him do the B.
Yeah.
Be like, ooh, you know how you made the B the same size as the happy?
Right.
You're going to have a problem.
Yeah.
Yeah. Your sign better say happy birthday.
Yeah. Right. Haday. Bert Haday.
This is where you could come in, Brian. They put the B down and you're like, too loud.
Yeah. Right. Yeah.
Your sign's too loud. It's not going to make it.
All right. So I told you about the dark sense of humor. All right. Which I have. So again, intelligent. What?
Oh, go ahead. Give me facts written. I would like facts written by Damon for 300.
So
what is
people who wear all black are more likely to be seen as reliable, serious, and confident. I wear a lot of dark clothes, mostly because I'm fat, but I wear a lot of dark clothes.
Ooh, this is dangerous.
Yeah.
Because you had to throw that because you're fat line in.
Yeah.
Because I was just going to say for a while there, I was calling Tina Mrs. Johnny Cash.
Oh.
Because all she it'd be like
the woman in black.
Yeah.
Yeah. Gotcha.
I'm like, how do you know which pants you're wearing? They're all black. All your shirts black. And then when. The other day she came out and was wearing like a blue shirt. And I was like, was it something happening?
Yeah.
Did someone die? Yeah. Like she'd be the one person not wearing black would indicate death.
Is there a group of elephants rushing our village right now? Someone dead. Someone dead. But no,
ooh, I was like, ooh, someone need to do laundry.
Yeah. But no. And I realized black, supposedly black is slimming. There's nothing slimming on me ever.
That's what, one of my first shows I had on a black shirt, black vest, black pants.
Yeah.
And I got up there and in the stage lights, suddenly it turned into black pants, slightly off black shirt, slightly gray vest.
Yeah.
And I was like, they say black is slimming. I decided to wear three different blacks.
Right.
Yeah. Still didn't work.
I am three times skinnier than I normally am right now.
I mean, it all matched like in my house. I got on stage and was like, ooh, there are different blacks and I'm showing them off.
Yeah. That's why like my son does it all the time. Black shirt over black shorts. I don't do that. I don't like two blacks, you know? I just don't like having, cause inevitably your shirt's faded more than your shorts or your short, you know what I mean? Or vice versa. And you're like, no, I'm not doing that. Last one, this still fits to me and you're going to see this one more probably.
So not your shirt.
Yeah. Not nice. This is snug. So it can take up to 20 minutes for your brain to realize that your stomach is full. Now, you know how fast I eat.
Yeah.
That's why I'm the size I am. Okay, because I was full 20 minutes ago, yet I'm still moving like a trooper.
I get to say, I get to see your esophagus being like, oh no. about that, there's more people coming to the party. I got an entire line up here,
right,
looking for room down in this hotel. So
it's kind of like
stretch out, guys.
It's kind of like when you're pouring a driveway, and the last concrete truck shows up full, and you need like 1 foot filled, 1 square foot, right? That's me eating. That foot gets full. You don't know yet. You just keep throwing all that concrete over the driveway. It just comes and comes and comes for the next 20 minutes. And then you're like, yeah, I think we got enough.
Hey, you guys need a a sidewalk anywhere?
Yeah. Right. The driveway, there's like a three foot step down into the garage, you know. The car falls off into the garage. I can't back this out now. There's no way I'm getting out of here.
There's no chance Tony Hawk lives here, right? You need a half pipe in the back?
Yeah, but that's exactly, I when I read this, I'm like, this is me to a T, because I do. I eat so fast that a lot of times, it's weird. If I'm talking with people and just taking my time, I'm full on like a fraction. You know,
conversely, doesn't that mean that if you stop eating, you do some stuff, 20 minutes later, your stomach can also be like, oh, I wasn't done.
Yeah, right.
Hopefully you didn't stray too far from the kitchen.
Right.
I was not finished.
That must be that's the rule with Chinese food, where you're hungry an hour later. It's probably your stomach going, listen, you got bored with eating all these little bites. Yeah. Okay. And picking up rice.
I
with
stacked
chopsticks.
Up all this rice down here. Turns out in a stack, it's not as big as you thought it was.
Yeah. 4,700 times with the chopsticks wasn't enough to get me full.
A few weeks back, John and Comedy Brian and I went to a Chinese restaurant.
Yeah.
And John's like, I'm buying. I'm like, all right. But I wasn't being a jerk. I was like, yeah, I'll take the chicken teriyaki at the Chinese place. The guy was like, small or large? I'm like, oh, it's regular. It's a small. And John's like, what are you on a diet? Get him the large.
Yeah.
Does the same thing to Brian. Goes over to John, the guy's like, do you want the small or large? And John's like, oh, yeah, I'll just take the small. You know what the large is? Family size.
Oh, no kidding.
Waiter did not say that at all. Just allowed for me and Comedy Brian, who is not overweight in any way.
Right.
just to order a full family size thing. And then John's dainty plate comes out. And I was like, you son of a bitch.
And you know, he's just looking at everybody else like,
You know how I know it was family size?
Yeah.
It didn't come with a spoon. It came with a serving ladle.
Did it really?
Yeah. So now I'm like trying to tongue my food out of the ladle.
Oh, you know what's awesome is I could picture that. That would be so great to be like, what is he eating? It's not soup. It's a whole plate of teriyaki chicken. Yeah. He's eating it with a ladle.
And then it was just. So I took home leftovers and Brian didn't want his and I was like, yeah, but it had shrimp in it. And I was like, well, I got to eat this at home because Tina won't eat it. And
right.
And my daughter's allergic to seafood. No, just to shrimp, I think.
Okay. Shellfish.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, no, I said, I don't know if it's more than that.
I was going to say,
I think it's just shrimp.
Yeah. That was a nice point out. I like that, Mac. You jump right on it.
17. I don't choose what they eat anymore. Yeah. That's on them.
Right.
Hey, and it's not like the one where it's like her throat closes up. She just breaks out in hives when she eats.
Oh, okay. Gotcha. So you're miserable.
Yeah. So it's not like, yeah. Oh, did we bring that pen thing?
Yeah. Right.
No. I needed room for my 20-minute snack.
So you will admit then those centered around me.
Oh, I caught that after fact too. And I use the word fact loosely.
Hey, I thought you were going to come.
Ted, here's some fun facts I just happened to find in my notebook about myself,
handwritten in my in my handwriting. Yeah.
With crayon.
Yeah, with crayon.
These look like they were written left-handedly with a slant in your notebook.
Did you eat the crayon by any chance when you were done?
Oh no, that's just Cheetos.
Yeah, that's just Cheeto dust.
That's just Cheeto dust. Cheeto Don't worry about that.
That's all good. It's not Frito dust. We know that. All right, how about a TCO of the week?
Scumbags of the chip aisle.
I know they are. TCO of the week. Florida man got caught feeding. Florida man. We already got it. Got caught feeding wild alligator. Resist arrest. And the quote says, he's a good boy and he loves bagels.
Wait, who's the good boy? The Florida man or the gator?
I'm not sure. But a Florida man.
Hold on. We'll find out.
Yeah. Stay tuned. There's more. A Florida
film
man
at 11.
Who allegedly resisted arrest after being caught illegally feeding an alligator named Hank. Now, is the alligator named Hank or is the Florida man named Hank?
Yeah.
In his in his neighborhood. Pond, described as a 10-foot beast, is a good boy and a good friend. Oh, Paul Fortin, 67. So Hank is the alligator, okay? I don't know if Hank knows his name, but Hank's the alligator. Paul, 67, was issued a citation by the Florida Fish and Wildlife Commission. But he was arrested by police and taken to the jail after he refused to accept the citation.
Not doing it.
Don't hand me that. No, don't hand me that.
Yeah. No, I'd rather pay bail and court fees.
Yeah.
I don't want that citation.
I just toasted and smeared a bagel for an alligator, and I don't want your citation, you know? What do they like? What do they like as toppings, I wonder? They like an everything bagel?
Probably salmon.
Right. If he's not possible, maybe
you
Paul.
You got any locks? I don't want it.
Right. So,
yeah. What? I just fed him some bagels, some cream cheese, a foot. Why you got to give me a month in my business about it?
Fortin, who says he's a disabled veteran. Are we talking about Hank or Fortin here? Yeah. I don't know.
Like, did he get disabled in the service or because he was feeding an alligator?
Right. That he regularly fed Hank the alligator. And in quotes, he's a good boy. He lets me pet him. That's what I'm doing in Florida with a wild alligator?
No.
I don't know what kind of PTSD this guy's got where this alligator's like, I ain't messing with
Hank. I don't know why they wasted the time giving him a citation. They just had to wait it out.
Yeah.
Eventually, there's going to be no more Hank.
Look, I know eventually you're going to want to go looking for discs. All right. So this is it's the thinning of the herd. You're going to clear yourself out. We're good. So, but it did say that he just sits there and loves bagels. He's such a good friend.
Well, I feel if I just threw you food, you'd be a good friend too.
You're right.
So maybe Hank's not too far off.
But I have no chance of putting my mouth anywhere around you and killing you. It's not going to happen.
I got to tell you though, Hank's not an idiot. Anything that you can throw frisbee style into a gator is probably the best
right,
food.
Right. You see him doing tricks like a beagle. He's jumping around doing flips.
Look, I can't afford an entire Frolf course. Yeah. So I just let the gator wander around the bayou.
I was going to say, it's so great when the goal moves. Yeah. I'm off by 3 feet. He'll get it. He'll get it.
Hey, man, I've already done hole three 6 times. Can you move down a little bit?
Yeah. Score. But it says the alligator lover added, it's illegal. It's totally illegal to do that. He didn't know it. How do you not know it's illegal to feed alligators?
It's Florida. How do you not know anything's illegal down there? Oh, we can't do this?
Well, then it says, yeah, I kind of knew that. I don't know. Maybe I'm Dr. Doolittle. That's his quote. But essentially, so this guy, now here's his picture. Okay.
Yeah. All right.
He looks like a gator feeder, you know?
Here's the thing. Did he test stuff? Like, did he throw other things first? Cheez-Its? No.
Right. All right. Right.
Nope. Oreos? Not having it.
So he wanted to bite me when I tried feeding him hot dogs, but he loves breakfast food, okay? I get him a McMuffin. I get to pet his head. I'll rub his belly. He'll roll over, you know? It's like, what do you do? You know? And then to tell people, I didn't know that was illegal. Anything to do with, like, wildlife in Florida is illegal. You can't even kill him. You can't, you know what I mean?
I would have thought he liked English muffins for the crunch. Right. Turns out bagels. Right. Who knew? Right.
He puts a little peanut butter on there. I thought you liked that. Just sucks the roof of his mouth.
I thought you liked those crooks and nannies.
Well, yeah, it would be great if his name was Thomas. He could feed him English muffins, but that's all right. But no, so when I read that, the title, I thought there might be a little more meat to it. Basically, this guy's just cuckoo.
No, it's all bagel. No meat.
He's just cuckoo, man. So he's just cuckoo. Yeah, I like feeding him bagels. He's such a good friend. No, I'm going to go with no. So.
All the other things afforded to do, this is the guy that gets a citation.
Right.
He's just throwing bread at a gator.
Right. Yeah.
Let nature take its course.
Yeah. Oh, here's the deal. When the gators had enough bagels.
It's like, when the gators have enough bagels or Hank runs out.
Yeah.
The gator will take care of the situation for you.
I feed him three every day and he's happy. So then as he's feeding the second one, some bird flies down and takes the third one. Oh, damn.
Oh, no. You know? Oh, no.
Ooh, yeah. He's got a bagel belt buckle on and it's bagel shaped.
No, he's just got a box of the in case of emergency break glass with just a single bagel in it.
Yeah, just one. He's like, it's not even toasted, Paul. I'm not going for that. But he named him Hank. So I guess Hank's a good gator.
Yeah.
I'll be honest, I watch videos of stuff like that where people, they go in and they pet their head and they're like, oh, well, this is domesticated. This. That's not a domesticated animal ever. Aren't those like the closest to dinosaurs? I mean, besides chickens, right? But
I saw a joke where someone was, a time traveler went back and the dinosaur were like, well, what's the future like? Okay, well, here's the thing. They eat your relatives in the shape of you. Cooked using your bones because they show them like you cooking with natural gas.
Yeah.
So it was just like one single tear rolling.
Yeah. Yeah. Spoiler alert.
Yeah.
It is not good for you. Yeah.
Yeah. So you're not there.
Right. All right. So we'll go right from there into a strange story. All right.
All right.
Strange. You're going to play the whole thing?
Yeah. Because last week Jordan didn't get it. So,
right.
Jordan, this one goes out to you.
Wait, what?
This is Strange Stories. With Damon and Ted.
Ma, there's no more deviled eggs on the roof.
There it was.
There it is. There it is.
The Strange Stories intro.
All right. So Strange Stories.
Surprisingly shorter than the original.
Yes. Yes. Yeah. I was going to say. Yeah. Still had enough time to run down to the car, yeah, get something to drink. But top scientist apologizes for a joke after claiming a slice of sausage was a distant star.
Run that by me again.
Top scientist.
Got it.
Apologizes for a joke.
Right.
Claiming a slice of sausage was a distant star.
All right. I'm going to need some meat on these
bones. Yeah. Hank's probably on board.
Yeah. So far, I'm feeling this is just bagel.
Right. So it said you should never blindly trust anyone, no matter what kind of authority figure they are. We just got an important reminder of that.
Hey, you want to trust me with my sausage?
Yeah.
It's a distant star.
Hey, get closer.
Get a little closer.
So his name's Etienne Klein.
Wait, his name is E.T.?
E.T., yeah. He wants to phone home to a sausage. But it says he's a respected physicist and a particular...
I think he was.
Yeah, with particular expertise in the behavior of time. That stuff really does... I mean, that entices me. Like, I like that stuff. But some people that do this stuff are extremely wackadoo. I know there's science behind it.
On my Facebook originally, back when I first started on there, I put myself as vice president of flux capacitating.
How'd that work out for you?
At Dr. Emmett L. Brown Scientific Services. I got people reaching out to me like, can we compare notes on time travel theory?
Yeah.
And I was like, I don't have any theory.
Right.
Because we don't travel in time. I was like, you know how we travel in time? It's the future.
Yeah.
It's the future. Like, that's how we go.
I'm in the now.
Well, yeah, no, I got some straight up wackadoos coming out.
Right. And that's what I'm saying.
But so, I'm still in there as the vice president of.
Yeah.
I have two jobs.
Nobody likes a quitter.
I am a lead talent of That Checks Out.
Yeah, I saw that.
It was great because we're like 3 months into this, 8 months into this. You're like, hey, we should put that we work at our job as That Checks Out. And I'm like, hey, go check my Facebook. And you're like, I hate you.
Yeah.
Because yeah, from day one, I was like, feature talent.
Yeah. But so, like I said, I admire what these guys do. They're very intelligent, but I think their mind works too much to like a side that maybe doesn't even exist. You know what I mean?
I'm still trying to figure out how this guy like passed off a sausage as a star.
So, but it said he received a whole slew of awards for his academic work, participated in designing the Large Hadron Collider. I don't know what that is.
Collider.
No, collider. No, Mac.
Collider?
Dude, let that go.
Collider? Collider?
That over in Switzerland,
yeah,
they spent $8 trillion on a thing to strain pasta.
Yeah, right.
Seems legit.
Right. They must have bedazzled it or something. I don't know.
Damon's so, like, I knew that the God particle had something to do with pasta.
I'm Italian.
I'm Italian. Yeah,
I'm smart enough to know this. Yeah. That would strain almost enough pasta to feed me for an extra 20 minutes. So anyway.
You went to Fermilab looking for help with some other stuff.
Yeah, right.
Yeah. Can you firm me?
Yeah.
Oh, that's not what you do here?
Sir, you're going to have to take those popsicle sticks and duct tape off before I try.
What's this coupon for 5 for $5? I don't get it.
Right. Micro what? Yeah. Yeah. So in other words, you'd imagine he knows what he's talking about. All right. It is not a colander. It is a collider.
Yes, thank you.
All right? It's a collider. We learned a new word today, folks, and it's because I'm smart enough to comprehend it, and I'm intelligent enough to know it.
Use we very loosely.
Yeah. So
do you know what they collide there?
Pasta.
That, yeah.
I have no idea. Yeah,
it was coming. Yeah. It was coming.
But it says on July 31st, he shared a picture of a red spotty circle with his 92,500 followers. That's pretty good for being a scientist. You know what I mean? He claimed...
That's basically Damon's long form of going, nerd.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm like Ogre from Revenge of the Nerds. Nerds. Yeah. But it says he claimed that it was Proxima Centauri. All right. And it was captured by the James Webb Telescope, some 4.2 light years from Earth. Okay. And it's the nearest star to the sun. This was his claim on what he showed on his Twitter feed or whatever else. Okay. In quotes, the level of detail, a new world is unveiled every day, Klein wrote in French. As you'd expect, his followers marveled at the beauty, at the red thing in the photo. It was vibrant, fascinating. It had splotches on its surface. There's just one problem. The photo is not of Proxima Centauri. It's not even a star. It's a slice of chorizo sausage.
All the mysteries of the universe.
First off, this story got a lot more delicious to me. And I believe if that's sausage, probably that is a colander because they're probably making spaghetti.
This is funny because you could just see some guy at Johnsonville being like, wait a minute.
Yeah.
Let's back the train up here, Sally. Right. I got a beef to pick with you.
Right.
A beef sausage?
Yes. Yes.
Well, it's reason, probably pork.
But it says in space, no one will serve you sausage. Everybody makes mistakes, right? Well, this wasn't a mistake. He tweeted the picture with he tweeted it. Okay. Of the sausage star. Sausage star?
Nope.
Is that a real
thing?
Keep
going.
I'm going to Twitter.
Yeah.
Don't Twitter sausage star.
With full. Google
it. I'm going
it.
For it.
Did you mean Mike wrote? Never mind.
You put with it on full, that screen. Do yeah. not put it on this yeah. screen.
With full that knowledge. Screen. With full knowledge of what it is. A couple of days later, he took to Twitter again. First things first, he apologized for misleading thousands of people with what probably came from his breakfast.
He probably giggled. Forever. Look at him doing. Look
right.
at him doing.
Right. Well, because what he probably did is.
Can you believe that?
Oh my God.
That's not colander. I'm going to tell you that right now. So it says, in quotes, in view of certain comments, I feel obliged to specify that this tweeting showed an alleged picture of Proxima Centauri. It was a joke. I want to see how many followers he has now.
Right.
He had 92,500. They go, this guy's a scientist, world renowned. I want to know about him. He probably has like 92 followers, you know?
Here's the thing is that in the 1800s, they convinced people the moon is made out of cheese.
Yeah.
2022, this guy convinced people the star is made out of sausage.
This guy is merely made, 2000 years later, he's merely made a cheese and sausage platter. Okay.
Yeah. He's just telling you space is a charcuterie board. Yeah,
there's a Milky Way. Yeah, so, right. You know?
You know that James Webb telescope? So it was damaged by an asteroid belt or asteroid field came through there.
Okay.
And they were like, well, didn't you prepare for that? Like, yeah, about that. We just didn't know they'd be that big. they tested it for smaller size rocks hitting it. And they're like, yeah, well, you know, it's out there now. Nothing we can do. Too bad.
Yeah. You know what's cool, though? Is you have the telescope. You should know how big they were before you sent it out there. They look so much smaller up there. Did you ever look at them through the telescope? Oh, should have done that. You know?
It's like if people tested umbrellas under a sink.
Yeah.
I didn't know that the water would be that far apart.
I swear that I absolutely would love to go home later today, take a picture of a McMuffin, and be like, okay, I found a new planet. All right? There's eggs. There's cheese. There's sausage. This is a whole solar system right here. And by the way, it's going to my belly with about three of its friends. You know, so...
Yeah, you'd have the Hamburglar like booking the first SpaceX flight.
Right.
I'm going there.
Right. Right. But it says, could that mean there's chorizo floating in space somewhere? No. According to the contemporary cosmology, no object related to Spanish charcuterie exists anywhere else other than on Earth. So they use your word.
Do they know that?
But why did he mislead so many people in his own words? It says, let's learn to be wary of arguments from positions of authority. You know what? That is a good point.
Also, I feel like he got caught. Now he's like, I was just trying to show you shouldn't listen to people.
Right.
That's on you.
Right.
Not on me that I took a picture of my sausage, blew it up, put it on Twitter.
Yeah. And I wanted a Nobel Prize.
Yeah. And
I found it. It does kind of look like a star.
Yeah. He showed it to me.
I saw
it locally on the phone. But here's the thing. The guy was like, I was just testing the waters to see if people would like to see Twitters of my sausage. he's like, I'm glad I started with this one.
I was going to say, I've been sliding.
He needed sausage to be trending.
Well, yeah, that's why he started with this one.
Yeah.
You start with the other one, you're getting a citation.
You imagine if I was a scientist?
At best.
Yeah. They'd be like, I'd be like, okay, so here's the contour of the moon. They're like, that's a biscuit.
this guy is an idiot.
And that's gravy. You have a fork in your hand. You are not. This is not what we're doing.
This would be you. Yeah, I kind of like that star. Ted, do you think it'd be okay if I ordered like a second star?
Yeah.
You think they'd be upset?
It would.
Because you know you can buy a star, like a name a star for
right.
someone. Hey,
yeah.
Ted, I want to name the sausage star.
Yeah.
Do you think that'd be okay if I bought another star?
Think I should get a second? Is that too much?
Yeah.
Think I should get a second
one? The
one
that looks like a biscuit? I want to name it gravy.
So it said the $10 billion James Webb telescope was intended to replace the rapidly aging Hubble. It's the most powerful telescope ever launched into space, captures sharper images, and it's farther out. In fact, thanks to the telescope, we spotted the farthest galaxy humanity has ever observed. Now, I've heard of this thing. So how far away from here is it?
Well, I like how they spend all this money and all this stuff just for some guy to make a sausage joke.
Right. Yeah. Ooh. And you know what it is? It's been in his repertoire for a while. Yeah, yeah. He's like, man, if I could ever just get, whoa, they got a $10 billion telescope? Yeah. Get the sausage
if
out.
If they ever update this telescope.
Yeah. Right. Oh, it says right here.
Nearly 1 million miles.
It says 35 billion light years away from us. It crowned a photo of stars and galaxies. Huh. So light year.
I hope that the picture that they send back, I hope they send back video and it's just someone finishing your sentence right as you're doing it.
You know what I would, you know, or it's a perfectly in focus Sasquatch. You're like, how the hell do we get one all the way out there? And we found him. But yeah, when he's in the woods and I've got an iPhone 13 with the best camera on the face of the earth, he's still fuzzy or blurry. Yeah. Now, how does that happen?
I just think champion, buddy. Doing it. Ollie, oxen free. Yeah. Hope that translates into the 25 countries we're in.
So the last sentence in this story says, space, man, it's freaking weird. That's what it says.
Sausage, the final frontier. Yeah.
That's the first frontier.
Yeah. It kind of is.
To boldly go where every man has gone before. Sausage joke.
To boldly go. It's a first step for man. It's a second one ordered by Damon. That's how it goes.
Sensors indicate it's sausage.
It's, you say, sensors. Yeah. What is that coming at us? It's a sausage. It's 35 billion light years away. Who's holding it? A Sasquatch.
Red alert. Red alert.
Yeah. That is so great, though. That would be the whole thing, is you'd be like, that's a clear picture of a Yeti. I can see that right there. I know what that is.
30 years down the line, they show you the picture from behind the scenes, and it's just some dude holding up a photo.
You see the fingers? The fingers in the bottom? Oh my God, is that like a ring around the moon? No, that's his thumbnail. That's what that is.
Is that God's thumb? No, it's just Bob.
You know what's great? That's Bob's thumb.
Notice the barbecue sauce.
Yeah. That's wing sauce.
Was the McRib back?
Yeah. Right. Where can they find us, Ted?
Wait.
Huh?
I got something.
No, do you really?
You got something? I do. This is we're in the future right now,
wait,
right?
Wait for us to get to the end.
Wait. Hey, you guys want to know how my week was?
Do you guys want to know how my week was? This is the future. You want to know how my week was?
That will remain a mystery.
Apparently not. Go ahead, Mac. How was your week?
Wednesday was my last day at the G Center.
Get out of town.
For real.
Man. Nice. Drum roll, please. I like it.
Okay, you can do that one now.
So that was your news?
Yep.
Well, that was, I mean, I guess that was good, but wait, so is this is your full time here?
I mean, not really.
Prices just went up. Yeah. Entrepreneur.
All right, hit me again.
Hey, where can they find us, Dad?
Apparently now they can find us back in Damon's basement doing the podcast on our own. You can find all our previous episodes at thatchecksout.net. You can find us on all the socials, thatchecksout.wdt. That stands for With Damon and Ted. He's Damon. I'm Ted. We'll catch you next time. That Checks Out has been a TCO Productions. Thank you for listening.
That was professional. I like it. Sausage. Sausage.